electric jelly on the temples, strap on the electrodes, insert a mouth gag, then a jolt of electric current. It's a rapid response therapy that's been around a while. It's called ECT, electroconvulsive therapy, better known as shock treatment. Introduced to the US around the same time as lobotomies back in the 1940s, ECT still stirs strong emotions as a brutally archaic torture rather than a modern, useful treatment. But ECT is as common as ever, and there's only one reason why. It works.
I was under the bridge for a few days with the crackheads and the alcoholics. It was kind of like I was suicide by, it was just gonna be a slow death. I just wanted to sleep in a way.
A successful serial entrepreneur, Gary Halliday lost it all and found himself at Western Psychiatric in Pittsburgh.
They had given me an antidepressant and I wasn't responding. Being in that severe of a depression for a year or so, you know, they felt I was medication resistant at that point.
Out of options, doctors recommended that he participate in a clinical study.
And the study was ECT plus medication for 8 months.
It sounded terrifying and barbaric, but doctors insisted ECT could help.
I was desperate at that time. I was totally desperate. I had nothing, nowhere for me to go, you know, physically or emotionally. And, you know, it worked.
Usually people are referred to me because everything else has not worked.
During her time as the chair of psychiatric and behavioral sciences at Duke University, Sarah Lissenby has advanced our understanding of just how effective ECT can be.
ECT induces remission in upwards of 80% of people. It's very rapidly effective, and in particular, people with bipolar disorder with severe depression respond extremely rapidly to ECT.
ECT and DBS both rely on electricity. Electric current applied to the brain changes the way neurons connect to one another and even stimulates the growth of new neurons.
The brain is capable of rewiring itself quickly and in a profound way. Every time we learn a language or we learn to play the violin, we're changing the way the brain is wired up.